Banerjee. Today I am going to discuss about Class 9 ICSE syllabus first chapter, the Harappan civilization. The civilization is dated between the period of 2500 BC to 1750 BC. It was first discovered by Rakhaldas Banerjee and Dayaram Sahani in the year 1921 approximately. So this civilization is also known as the Indus Valley civilization because it is founded in the banks of the river Indus, and it is also named as Harappan civilization because Harappa was the first site discovered by these archaeologists. So the main two sites of the civilization are Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, and they were discovered in 1921 and 1922 respectively. There are some sources from where we get to know about these places, like the Great Bath, which is located in Mohenjo-daro, then the citadel, the seals, the archaeological remains, and as well as some things get to know from the things which we got there, like the dancing girl, the bearded man, and all these. The Great Bath. First, we will discuss about the Great Bath because this is one of the main archaeological remains that we found in this site. The Great Bath was used for auspicious ceremonies and for ordinary purposes as well. And the measurement of the bath was 108 into 180 feet with a bathing pool with it. And the bathing pool was 39 feet in length and 28 feet in breadth and 8 feet deep. There were many other sites that were discovered along with these sites, like Lothal, Kalibangan, Dholavira, and the most recent one is Rakhigiri. It is near Haryana. So in all these sites, the people have also found granaries, which shows that the agriculture was their main occupation. So the great granary is situated in Harappa, which was a very big one, as because there were 6 rows of granaries in Harappa. On each granary we have found circular pits which were used for threshing grains, and this is proved as because we have found wheat and barley remains in those circular pits. The great granary is 15.23 into 6.09 meters in length and breadth, and they were particularly used for these purposes only. The Harappan city was divided into two parts. The one was the citadel and the other was the lower town. The citadel was in a raised platform. The citadel got its height from the platforms of the mud brick houses which were built below it. The citadel was separated from the lower town by a wall. The great granary, the great bath, the assembly hall and the workshops were located in the citadel only. The normal people, the ordinary people and their works were carried down in the lower town. In the Harappan sites, we also found seals. These seals were rectangular in shape and some were of square, and there were also circular shaped seals. These seals represented or reviewed the script, trade and the daily beliefs of the people. In the scripts we also found the Pashupati avatar of Shiva or Vishnu, which shows that there was a yogic posture of Pashupati surrounded by many animals. This shows that the Harappan people believed in Vishnu or Shiva. The seals also tell us about that trade also occurred at those times, and the one horn bull, buffalo, tiger, goat, elephant, these were also found on those inscripted on those seals. The script of the Harappan civilization is not yet deciphered. It is very evident that if we decipher those scripts, it will be very easier for us to get more facts about the Harappan civilization. Many sculptures were found in the Harappan and Mohenjo-daro sites. Like one of them is a yogi, a statue of yogi which has a shawl worn in his shoulder, and his eyes are half closed and he is having beard. This is one of the most important and most prominent example of sculpture found at Mohenjo-daro. Another example of sculpture is the dancing girl. this dancing girl is having resting one hand on her hip and the other hand is at her legs, and she is having a bowl in her left leg. And this is one of the important sculptures that is found in Mohenjo-daro. And this the miniature of this dancing girl is preserved at the National Museum in Delhi. So these are some of the examples of sculptures and bronze images that are found in Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. Now we will discuss about the religion which was followed by the Harappans. It is often debated that the Harappans followed somewhat similar a religion similar to Hinduism, as because we have found the Pashupati avatar of Shiva, the mother goddess, and the trees, the animals and trees, seals that have animals and trees, which shows that the beliefs of the Harappans were somewhat similar to that of Hinduism. We get to know about this because we have found the mother goddess. We have found that they worship the mother goddess, which was something similar to that of goddess of earth. We again found a dockyard. We again found a dockyard which was situated in Lothal, and it was connected with channels to the Gulf of Cambay. This shows that this dockyard was an important place for trade and commerce, and the Harappans carried on extensive trade with other civilizations. The entire area of the Harappan civilization is triangular in shape and accounts for about 129,600 square kilometers and was the largest among the ancient civilizations. It extended from Supta Gendar on the sea coast of South Balochistan in the west to Alamgirpur in the upper Ganga Yamuna Doab in western UP in the east, and from Manda in Jammu in north to Bhagatrap in Narmada estuary in the south. In this way, the Harappan culture covered parts of Punjab, Haryana, Sindh, Balochistan, Gujarat, Rajasthan, and at the fingers of the western Uttar Pradesh. Consequent to the partition of India, the main centers of civilization, that is Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Chandu-daro, Supta Gendar, are now in Pakistan. Some of the centers of this civilization are in India. They are Manda, Banavali, Kalibangan, Alamgirpur, Lothal, Ropar, and Rangpur. In recent years, many extensions of this civilization in Gujarat and Punjab have been discovered. Dholavira is the most prominent among them. Now, at last, we will discuss about the decline of the Harappan civilizations. There are many reasons which led to the decline of this civilization, and we will discuss some, like floods and climatic changes. It is held by scholars that the amount of rainfall in the Indus region increased slightly around 3000 BC and then declined in the earlier part of the second millennium BC. Others believe that decrease in fertility of the soil because of increasing salinity caused by the expansion of the neighboring desert led to the decline. The second cause for the decline is deforestation. Since Indus Valley civilization was a Bronze Age culture, enormous quantities of wood was needed to produce bronze. Wood was also needed to produce jewelry, to bake bricks, pottery, stoneware, and to make boats and furniture. This could have led to deforestation, leading to climatic change in the region, and finally to the decline of this area and as well as the civilization. Another important reason for the decline of the civilization is attacks from the outside areas. Like some historians like Mortimer Wheeler believe that invading Aryans destroyed the Indus settlements. Mortimer Wheeler believed that in the last phase of Mohenjo-daro, men, women and children were massacred in the streets and houses, as is evident from the skeletons of 13 males and females and one child lying in the inner room. This shows that the attacks have also played an important role in the decline of this vast civilization. And another important and very prominent cause for the decline of the Harappan civilization is earthquake. It is believed by some scholars that earthquakes caused changes in the course of the Indus River, which led to the inundation of the hinterland of Mohenjo-daro. It might also have caused incalculable damages. So, culminating all these events, we can come to a solution or conclusion that these All these events culminated to the decline of the Harappan civilization or the Indus Valley civilization. Thank you for watching the video. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel History Lessons for more historical facts. And please comment on the comment box below for your opinion. And don't forget to click the bell icon for regular updates. And the important photos and the images of the lecture will be given at the end of the video. And the picture of the book which I referred will be given at the end of the video. Thank you. Thank you.